750 million meals are served on aircraft every year. As the holiday season builds up, the worry of trips being ruined by delays is probably the biggest concern for the thousands of passengers leaving Heathrow every day. But according to health officials, they face a far greater threat from airline catering. A recently published survey has shown that almost a quarter of the meals being served on flights from Heathrow contain excessive levels of bacteria which could cause food poisoning. The figures have so alarmed environmental health officers that they're holding a conference with airline caterers at Hounslow to try and improve standards. Most airline food is cooked, chilled, and then transferred to the plane where it's reheated before serving. Health experts say caterers aren't abiding by government guidelines about the preparation of the food, and that's why many meals are contaminated.
I think the public has a right to expect that all that can be done will be done to give it food that is safe. Just because the counts are high doesn't mean that it was all unsafe. These are indicators that better standards could be achieved. I think we want a high standard of airline food, and we want there's no reason to accept anything less. Just because it's on an aeroplane, it should be just as safe as food that's served to you in a restaurant.
The survey was prompted by one of the worst ever food poisoning incidents 5 years ago. 766 people on British Airways flights to the US were taken ill after eating seafood contaminated with salmonella. One victim, Ian Collins, was paid £1,500 compensation after suing the airline.
That night after I arrived in the US, I fell ill and it just got worse and worse, and I was taken into hospital. I spent the next 13 days in a hospital in the States, having had salmonella diagnosed from the airline food which I had eaten. And in fact, it was about 5 weeks before I was well enough to return to work.
It's hoped that today's conference will help reduce the risk to passengers like Ian and bring airline catering into line with government guidelines. This is Jane Ball for Thames News.